I do believe that the question of safety is probably is clearly very important. Obviously, as I said before, it would have to be shown to have an effect that mattered to people in terms of their functioning. But clearly, safety here is a large issue. One expects that if the drug is intended to treat otherwise normal people, and critically, we expect that the drug would be taken by many, many people, many more people presumably than most of the drugs we approve. We clearly want to establish that the drug is quite safe, whatever that means. And we would expect that there would need to be very many patients exposed to the appropriate doses, probably for much longer periods of time, perhaps, than we ordinarily require for the treatment of a bona fide abnormal condition. But I do want to make one point here, and again, it speaks to the question of, perhaps it speaks to the question of, are we treating a disease or are we treating folks who we just want to make better than normal. And as I said, we would require considerable safety information. But I just want to raise the question, and again, we've never been faced with this issue, but I just want to raise the question. Every drug approval requires a balancing, if you will, of the risks and the benefits. One could imagine, I suppose, and this is perhaps something people might want to talk about, but one could imagine a treatment for an otherwise normal condition, let's say enhancing cognition, that provided such a large benefit on a function that society considered to be important, for example, cognitive function, such a large benefit that maybe we would tolerate some more